Enable notifications by ringing the bell. Shazam!
Sorry. Sorry.
Nate, okay, look, we've made a bunch of jokes about getting struck by lightning. Micah isn't even here this time. You True. Think this is going to be the time? No, no.
I mean, why not, man? I mean, honestly, to me, I just feel... Well, I know, I'm not Billy Batson, all right? So I'm not going to turn into Shazam, but if I do get hit by lightning, maybe something will happen. Maybe, you know, maybe it'll give me enhanced speed or something. You know, that actually, that's just the Flash.
I mean,
my
to be fair...
My friend got hit by lightning and it stunted his growth. That's the thing that can happen.
I mean,
that's like the world's worst superpower.
It's yeah, I know,
like,
right?
It's just like, what is your superpower?
I can't reach things on the top shelf.
Well, I mean, like, the thing is, you know, it'll hit Nate directly in the enclosure of his pants. So, you know, technically he'll get his zip zapped.
Ooh. What?
Okay.
You have an odd fetish.
No.
Fetish movie.
It's a joke from MASH.
Okay.
And then after that, it's like, after that, he's been crazy about stormy weather. And then they start singing Stormy Weather. Anyway.
All right,
It's a bit from MASH that's real hard to make work.
Shazam's one of the sillier DC properties. But in terms of its popularity. It's one of the more popular, silly stories.
Yeah, that's...
So...
Yeah.
All I really know of Shazam is from playing Injustice.
Yeah,
yeah, that's fair.
Which, what happened to him in Injustice? Holy hell. Oh, God. So, all right, anyway. First news I heard about this film was that the Dwayne Rock Johnson was scheduled to be Black Adam, which I
and
thought
I'm like,
was,
all right.
Was pristine good yeah, casting.
I would do it.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm in.
And
you got me.
Then the next thing I heard was that Zachary Levi was going to be Shazam or Captain Marvel.
Yeah, they can't call him Captain Marvel anymore.
No, because of
Marvel's
yeah,
Captain Marvel.
Miss Marvel, Captain Marvel, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So, the thing that sticks out to me is that Zachary Levi has never struck me as someone who has been particularly buff. He's had the skinny muscular frame from Chuck,
mm-hmm,
in which he did killer work in that. But from what I understand, he's actually put on a lot of muscle to portray Shazam.
This is going
to
be real weird.
Because here's the thing about Zachary Levi. He has a delivery that, to him, he almost seems like a kid who's in an adult's body.
Which is actually
what
Shazam
exactly
is.
And now that I think about that, and then when I thought about that more and more, I'm just like, I will definitely give this a look and see what Zachary Levi brings to the table.
There's a
Justice
League...
That sounds
League,
like it could work.
So. There's a Justice League comic where... It's they're trying to decide how to split up, and you just see a frame of Captain Marvel going, "I'll team up with Power Girl," and it's just like, "Yep, he's still going through puberty."
Yep. Well, of course.
Yep.
He's still a kid,
and you just see Power Girl just going.
There was one, I forget which one it was. It was a Justice League movie. It was a Flashpoint, a Justice League Flashpoint,
yeah,
where they showed an alternate future where there was supposed to be peace between the Amazonians and the Atlanteans.
Oh, and they did the Amazons
ruined.
Attack bit, yeah.
But then it all got ruined when Aquaman and Wonder Woman had an affair, and Mira got jealous
Bone?
And tried to kill Wonder Woman.
Bone!
And then after that, a whole war broke out. And in the midst of that, there was a fight that happened between Shazam and Wonder Woman. And she tricked him into saying Shazam.
Uh-huh.
And he turned back into Billy Batson. And then she proceeds to pick him up
and just
stab him and kill him.
And it's just like, well,
like,
that was easy.
I was just like, Jesus H. God. And then I saw that I played in, and then I forgot. Oh wait, I've played Injustice. I know what happens to him in that.
But also, Mira's a fucking crazy person.
Not,
there's a comic where she starts to throw a tank at people, and Aquaman has to go, "We're not killing anybody," and she goes, "Ah, fine."
Well,
Mira's a fucking crazy warrior.
That's how she was raised her entire life. I'm not going to fault her for that.
But anyway, This.
Anyway, enough talk. How about you?
Yeah. We're going to do this.
Yes.
Let's do it.
Let's do thing. All right.
You run from foster homes in 6 counties. I can take care of myself.
Okay.
When you're 18, give these people a chance. Because that's what they're giving you.
This is Billy Batson. Make sure you make him feel at home.
They seem nice, but don't buy it. It gets real Game of Thrones around here. Dude, just messing around. You look at me and you're like, why so dark? You're a disabled foster kid. You've got it all.
Wow.
What would you pick?
Ooh.
Everybody chooses flight. You know why?
So they can fly away from this conversation.
No, because heroes fly.
What, you need your fake family to stand up for you? Hey.
That'll work.
Sorry about that. Go, go, go. Grab him. Get out the way.
Yoo-hoo. Good night.
Sayonara.
Okay. What?
Billy Batson. I choose you as champion.
Gary?
Hello?
This doesn't look like my stop.
Say my name so my powers may flow through you.
But I don't know your name, sir.
Shazam.
Are you for real?
Say, okay! Shazam?
Holy shit!
Holy
I'm
shit.
Big now!
Wow.
It's me, it's Billy!
What is happening?
You're the only person I know that knows anything about this Caped Crusader stuff.
Can I...
Oh, yeah. That's crazy, right?
What are your superpowers?
Superpowers, dude? I don't even know how to pee in this thing.
You have super strength. Can you fly?
Really? It's like a trap, or not trap remix, but it's like a... It's Stay Humble by Kendrick Lamar.
Why are you talking? Be humble. Sit down. You know, I don't think that's gonna buff out.
Your phone's charged.
What the hell? Sorry. It's like, oh, sorry, I was an apple.
Oh, crap.
Gentlemen. Ow.
You have bullet immunity.
I'm bulletproof.
You're dead.
Oh, God.
Sorry about your window. Welcome for not getting robbed.
Oh, hey, sup, I'm a superhero.
Sup, I'm a superhero.
This yes. looks real
Okay,
dumb.
I'm very interested in this now.
All right, I'm just going to find
that looks pretty cool.
Cast list.
Okay, so Zachary Levi definitely... Hit the nail on the head.
Yeah,
right
all
there.
Right. He's got it.
He's got it good, dude. Holy crap! And also the kid not yeah the kid yeah nonchalantly Joe he's like, what is your name? Shazam. For real?
Just
say it. All right.
Okay.
Shazam.
Wait. Okay, the film went into pre-production in 2008.
Yep.
And Dwayne The Rock Johnson was considered to star as the villain Black Adam, but the project fell through.
Yeah.
Officially announced the film in 2014, with Johnson attached to a star as either Shazam or Black Adam. He would later be cast in January 2017 to lead a solo Black Adam development project.
Okay.
So he's not the villain. Oh, yep, okay. Dr. Shyvana is the villain. Cool.
Okay. So... Black Adam is instead going to be developed by itself. Now, imagine, if you will, a supervillain movie instead of a superhero movie. It'd be like if Suicide Squad was done right.
Okay, so just running this down. So we have...
Go for it.
We have Billy Batson,
yes.
Obviously. Yeah. So we have Freddie Freeman... who ends up being Captain Marvel Jr.
Huh.
And later, I think, becomes just straight up the Rock of Eternity, I think. Actually, so originally, he was
Rock
Shazam.
Of Eternity, that sounds like an awesome, like, hair metal band.
Right, but it's actually the thing where they draw their powers from.
No,
we
no,
have
I get you.
Grace Fulton as Mary Bromfield, who ends up being Mary Marvel. Eugene Choi, who is part of... Like, there's a lot of characters that are being thrown around the newly created Shazam family. Eugene Choi, Darla Dudley, Pedro Pena. So, yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, so basically, they figure out that Billy Batson can share the powers around.
Very nice.
Mm-hmm. So, that might be happening.
It'd be interesting.
The Shazam elite. Yeah. The Shazam family.
Also, Jimon Hounsou is playing Shazam, and he's also playing a role in Aquaman.
Oh, Jimon Hounsou's playing the old sage Shazam.
Yeah, and nice. The Fisherman King in Aquaman.
Ooh.
So he's playing two separate roles.
Oh, wow.
So he's the Josh Brolin of this.
Oh, and he was also Papa Midnight in the Constantine series.
Yeah.
Which is real good.
Well, just the one movie.
No, the series, the TV series, I think.
Oh, he portrayed it in the series,
Wait.
Too.
Oh, no, this is actually the movie. Never mind.
Oh, I was going to say.
I got real excited. I was like, oh, man, are we... Yeah, sorry about that.
No,
I got
okay.
real excited,
okay.
too, because the...
Because I loved him as I loved him as Papa Midnight in that. I loved the chair scene in that film because John Constantine, John Wick, mm-hmm. Keanu Reeves. He loves playing characters named John. Okay.
Oh, dude, he was Horace in the old terrible Stargate movie?
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. All right. Okay.
Jimon Hounsou, dude. Guy's awesome.
I love that old terrible Stargate movie so much.
A lot of people.
It
do.
Was a really good movie.
It's really good.
It's really good. Stupid.
Do you know
movie?
Why David like Spader it. Signed on to that movie?
James Spader.
James Spader. David Spader. What the hell?
David Spader.
What the
Spader.
Hell? Okay. I don't know why I got his name wrong because I really like James Spader. The reason that he signed on to that movie is because he read the script and thought it was so bad that it would never get a sequel, so he would only have to do the role once.
Nah.
And then, lo and behold, here comes Stargate SG-1.
Where, I mean, he wasn't in it.
No,
so
I know, but still, it merited enough popularity to
and
bring us one of the best sci-fi TV series of
oh,
all time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Agreed.
I mean...
Damn straight.
There you go.
He was in The Legend of Tarzan. He was in, this guy's been in a bunch of stuff.
Well, he's a very talented actor. Jimon Hounsou, I think, well... my favorite role of his in terms of like in terms of acting bravado, Blood Diamond, where he played Solomon Vandy, a prisoner of a diamond encampment who's taken away from his family,
mm-hmm.
and then his son is made into a pretty much heroin addicted child soldier, and he does everything he can to get his son back.
So he was Korath the Pursuer in Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, yeah. He was, yeah. He
and
got,
he's going to
he
be
got the
in...
side of his head ripped out by Dave Bautista.
He's going to be in Captain Marvel.
Oh, he's probably going to play the same character.
He is.
Nice. Very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God. Okay.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
This guy's getting around.
Well,
I respect it.
I'm very excited for everything that's going on now. I mean, the DC Expanded Universe, I think now that Infinity War has hit... And, like, everyone's on this kind of, not high, but sort of on this breather from what they just experienced with Infinity War.
Yeah.
Now is the chance for DC to really step up and try and
yeah.
grab a hold of that cinematic universe pie.
This is the time to, like, the iron's hot, strike.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because, honestly, people are, well, I'm not going to say people are sick and tired of Marvel films, but... I've heard, like, through the grapevine that people want something more than the Marvel Cinematic Universe, in which I get that.
Yeah.
I think it's more just people are holding things to a higher standard because of the Marvel Cinematic
Universe. No, I get that. I get that, too. In which that's why
we would like to see more things done that well.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, in which I was really hoping that the Mummy film would do that. But, hey, you know, blame Tom Cruise because... Yeah, do you know how bad Tom Cruise's creative team effed that movie up?
Oh, real bad.
Because, mm-hmm. here's the thing. Tom Cruise's character was originally just a pawn mm-hmm. in the film. And Sophia Boutella was the main character. She's the freaking mummy. The film should be all about her, but instead, no. They expanded Tom Cruise's part. They rewrote the script to fit Tom Cruise's, Tom Cruise's demands, and then he agreed to sign on, and it turns into one of the biggest cinematic deuce drops I've ever paid witness to.
Which is sad because Sofia Boutella does such good work.
She deserved better.
She deserved better.
Oh God! All right, we're actually at the limit right now. So, so thank you all very much for tuning in. This was the trailer for Shazam. If you all are excited for this, let us know in the comments down below. And I guess until next time, signing off. I'm Nate.
I'm Ben.
I'm Clinton.
Shazam!
And Damn we'll it, Nick.
And we'll see you later, everyone. Peace out.
We have enough power grid problems.